Hi, welcome to the NBA show. My name is Morten Jensen, and today we'll be discussing the Brooklyn Nets, who just traded for James Harden a couple of weeks ago. Stay tuned. So right off the bat, I just want to level with you. I was not a personal fan of the trade for James Harden, because ultimately, when you watch him play, he is a guy who loves to have the ball in his hands. In fact, only 15% of his shots were assisted in the 2019-2020 NBA season. And when you have a guy like Kyrie Irving handling the rock to the extent that he does, as well as having a Kevin Durant who scores almost 30 points a game, it does make you question whether that fit is, well, a good fit. Now, I want to preface this by saying I actually do hope that they manage to succeed. The NBA is always better when you have good teams. So I'm not rooting against the Nets. In fact, I'm not rooting against anyone. But I will say that I am slightly skeptical. It's one thing to be an isolation player like Harden. Isolation play can be a good play if you're good at it, and James Harden certainly is. So that's fine. The problem becomes in playoff context. If your primary strength is being an isolation scorer, does that work well with two other high usage offensive players? That remains to be seen. I do have questions about how it would work and how they could figure something out, but I also might have an idea how it could work. So as we know, traditional NBA positions has more or less gone out the window, right? Yet we still have this tendency to classify guys as point guards and shooting guards and wings and bigs and all this, you know, these types of descriptions. When it comes to James Harden, most frequently we talk about him as a guard because he has played point guard. Normally for the career, he's been a traditional shooting guard. But I would actually argue that for him, that becomes a huge asset because Kyrie Irving, who is known for being a scorer and not necessarily a great playmaker, it kind of allows them, those two guys, to just switch positions. If James Harden becomes your traditional point guard, and we know he has the passing chops to actually get the ball moving because he's led the league in assists at over 11 per game, maybe there's a way there where he, when he has the ball, instead of becoming the primary shot taker, becomes the primary playmaker. Having a guy like Kyrie Irving and also Kevin Durant, you know, running around the court, moving off the ball with tons of floppy action, that has to be just a huge asset for James Harden to have. In Houston, those guys were, what, Russell Westbrook and Eric Gordon? That's, you can't compare Eric Gordon and Russell Westbrook to Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant when it comes to shooting prowess. And having those guys to space the floor for Harden, so when he does assert himself offensively, he would have all the space in the world to do so, that could be a hugely interesting lineup. But I think ultimately you have to just turn the ball over to Harden and make him sort of the engine. Now, that leads to another question. Would Kyrie Irving be willing to take more of an off-ball role? That remains to be seen. We know Kevin Durant can do it. He did it in Golden State. He did it in Oklahoma City back in the day. He's done that. He is a guy who doesn't really need to have a whole lot of plays called for him in that sense. He can move. He can spot up. He can take the two dribble drives. He can do a bunch of weird stuff. Like, he's the X factor. He's the guy you can just throw in there and he'll go get you buckets. Like, you don't really have to worry about him. So it's primarily the dynamic between Kyrie Irving and James Harden that needs to be figured out. And given that both of them are very often on the ball and dribbling a ton, someone has to relent. And I think that player should be Kyrie Irving because he's just not the same caliber of playmaker as James Harden. It ultimately boils down to buying into the strengths of what you are as a player. And for Harden, his primary strength outside of isolation scoring is passing. He sees the court in a fantastic way. We don't really spend enough time just praising the court vision of James Harden. So we're so focused on him dribbling and asserting himself as a scorer, we never really figured out what could he do otherwise to fit well into this Net roster. We were so concerned about him being a spot-up shooter because, like I said, only 15% of his shots were assisted, that we never considered that he should just be the engine that ran the team. Because we already had our assumption made that that was Kyrie Irving because he was a point guard. This is why positions are dumb, pointless, outdated. It just doesn't make sense. Kyrie is a good shooter. He's a good scorer generally. He can find every ounce of space that he needs on the court just by being savvy and being himself. By being set up by James Harden, his efficiency should go through the roof. So it's just a matter of flipping those positions around, or the perceptions of those positions, and make Harden, you know, the guy who takes the primary decisions. Does that work with Kyrie? That remains to be seen. But I think that is the one thing they can't do, at least offensively, to make this thing valid in the long term. Now, defensively, they're going to be a train wreck because DeAndre Jordan at age 32 is no longer that guy. I mean, Nikola Vucevic ate his lunch during the first game that James Harden played for the Brooklyn Nets. And if that wasn't a testament to where DeAndre Jordan is defensively now, I don't know what is. But that's a whole other debate for a whole other video. Right now, let's take care of the offense. And the way that we do that, if we're the Brooklyn Nets, give James Harden the ball and make Kyrie Irving deal with it.